direct from Detroit, Motor City, USA. The Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the North American International Auto Show.
Name is what defines you. Your name is what makes you who you are. Unique. And nobody can take that away from you. Not now. Not tomorrow. Not the day after tomorrow. There is only one you, like there is only one of us. With everything that it means.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome President and CEO Jeep Brand, Mike Manley.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, good afternoon, everybody. I know it's been a long day for many of you, so thank you for hanging around for the Jeep press conference. You know, 3 years ago, Chrysler Group had a press conference here at the Detroit Auto Show. And many of you will remember at that time we herded 500 steer down Washington Boulevard just outside this building. And, you know, we were trying to avoid the razor-sharp horns at the time. Well, that may have seemed like fun at the time, but little did we know that we would not be able to avoid all of the hazards that were in store for us. You know, looking back, it does seem like a lifetime ago, and I guess in many respects, it is. Today, Chrysler is a very different company and striving to become a great company. It was only 14 months ago that we at Chrysler Group laid out our plans from a brand and product perspective that would start this company on its journey, a journey of recovery. You know, and many at the time commentated that those plans were ambitious, stretching, and that was certainly true. They were, and they absolutely needed to be. But what was also clear was that the Jeep brand had a significant role to play. Frankly, it's no stretch to say that the Jeep brand reflects what America is all about. Probably more than any other brand out there. Ingenuity, reinvention, can-do attitude, and becoming all that you can be to the fullest extent of your abilities. But Jeep is also a brand that lets us believe in possibilities. It lets us do what seems impossible. Jeep helps us realize some of the most important things in life. It enables and facilitates our dreams of adventure. And like no other brand, Jeep both takes you there and gets you back. The noise here wasn't planned. Now, 70 years ago, Jeep vehicles, as you know, helped the world emerge from a period of war. And really, from that point onwards, they've enabled ordinary people to follow their dreams of taking extraordinary journeys through life. The vehicles we make don't just give you the ability to go from point A to point B, they provide a mindset that's all about freedom for the soul. They help you say who you are and where you want to be. So I truly speak on my behalf and the behalf of all of my Jeep team when I say it's an absolute privilege to be here as part of this great story. So yes, it's great to be back in Detroit, and I'd like to start by sincerely thanking all of you for being with us today for the Jeep press conference. Of course, it's a lot more fun standing here knowing that 2010 was, without doubt, a good year for the Jeep brand. You know, we enjoyed successes along the way, including the introduction of our flagship vehicle, the 2011 Jeep Grand Cherokee. Now, in November 2009, we presented our five-year business plan, and I stood before many of you and said that we would strive to return the Jeep brand to its historical place as the number one SUV brand in the world. And to quickly put us on our way, we said that by the end of 2010, we would either renew or refresh the entire Jeep lineup. And as a result of those actions, we would noticeably increase our sales and our share. So today, we owe you a state of the Jeep brand update. Thank you. So, as you know, the Jeep brand is Chrysler Group's truly global brand. We sell our vehicles in over 120 countries. And I'm pleased to report from a sales and share standpoint, we did indeed make significant progress both here in North America and in our international markets. Now, we finished 2010 24% up year over year on a global basis, and here in the US, 26%. Now, even more telling is that every Jeep model saw double-digit sales increases in 2010 compared to 2009. So we know 2009 wasn't a benchmark year that any of us really wished to remember. But what may be more indicative of progress is the fact that Jeep reached its highest retail sales in the month of December here in the US than any other month since May 2008. And just to remind you all, the industry in 2008 was around 13.5 million. So to achieve our highest retail sales months for over 2 years in an industry that still has some recovery, I think indicates that the brand is making progress. So what did we do and how did we do it? Well, as I said, back in November 2009, we made a commitment that by the end of 2010, every Jeep model in the Jeep brand lineup would be either renewed or significantly refreshed. So allow me, if I may, to remind you of some of the product actions we've taken over the last 12 months. Now, for Liberty, we started the year by launching the new Renegade model. This was clearly styled to express the capability of this vehicle. And in Los Angeles, we launched another new model, the Liberty Jet, which you can see behind me and is in fact over there on the show floor. This vehicle was a direct response to consumers in the premium end of the market looking for a unique upscale appearance in a Jeep SUV. We also refreshed the 2011 Patriot, updating the front and rear styling whilst making significant improvements to ride and handling. And again, this was in direct response to customer feedback. The new 2011 Wrangler also received significant upgrades and improvements. We took that unique combination of legendary Jeep capability and open-air fun, and we made it even better. Now, because comfort and capability can peacefully coexist, the new 2011 Wrangler received a completely new interior, which significantly improves driver and passenger comfort, adding features across all Wrangler models that just weren't seen before. Now, for Sahara, we introduced the body-colored hardtop. And again, this dramatically changes the exterior appearance of this vehicle. So combined, Wrangler's great new interior and premium appearance on the exterior of Sahara has really broadened this vehicle's appeal. And from a sales perspective, year-over-year Wrangler volumes have grown on a global basis by 26%. Now, that's the second highest year-over-year growth of any Jeep product, and really proves that Wrangler truly is the icon of the brand. But by far, the biggest news for 2011 model year was the all-new Jeep Grand Cherokee. And the timing of this vehicle could not have been better, with the full-size segment enjoying significant year-over-year growth. And since its launch, the Grand Cherokee has received consistently positive reviews and a host of awards. Now, Grand Cherokee is the most luxurious Jeep ever. And with the stunning new interior that it has and its world-class interior, it is also our most capable vehicle as well, with quadra-lift suspension and select terrain systems. Above all, it's built with an unprecedented level of quality and craftsmanship. But with Grand Cherokee, we didn't rest on our laurels. The vehicle has seen significant demand in the premium end of the market. And to respond to this, we recently introduced the new Overland Summit. Now, the Overland Summit makes a permanent home in the Grand Cherokee lineup as the most luxurious, distinctive, and comprehensively equipped Jeep ever. While the fantastic reception Grand Cherokee received has translated already into significantly improved sales. Last month, Grand Cherokee reached its highest retail sales volume in any month for over 4 years. So as you can see, we have taken significant action right across the Jeep range. But of course, there's one vehicle that I haven't spoken about. And that brings me on to the final part of our product commitments. And that, of course, is the Jeep Compass. Now, the compact SUV segment is the largest SUV segment in the world, with more than 3.5 million vehicles registered globally and almost 350,000 registered here in the US. So clearly, for us at Jeep, it's a very, very important segment. Now, customers already offered, the Compass already offered our customers a high level of standard equipment along with unsurpassed fuel economy. But because of its styling and capability, comments such as, is it really a true Jeep, have often been made. Well, for 2011, we have completely addressed those concerns. The new 2011 Jeep Compass will be in showrooms across the country tomorrow and here at Cobo right about now. Ladies and gentlemen, the all-new 2011 Jeep Compass. Thank you. Well, as you can immediately see, I meant what I said. The look of this vehicle clearly shows the family resemblance to the premium 2011 Grand Cherokee. It's absolutely unmistakable. This new Compass is genetically engineered with the best of what its siblings brings to the table. But it comes in a size, shape, and attitude all of its own. Compass has a new face and a purposeful new attitude. The chrome details on the classic Jeep grille, a completely new front end, muscular hood that shows a subtle power bulge, and it's also echoed in the fenders. Projector fog lamps, new body colored, side cladding, and slimmer roof rails. 17-inch aluminum wheels and a new rear fascia. But it's not just the outside. Inside, owners are rewarded with premium materials everywhere they look, which includes soft touch trim panels, backlit switches, as well as our new Jeep brand steering wheel, which is packaged with cruise control. Add to that a long list of standard features that add comfort, convenience, you end up with, very importantly, a great value package. Now, especially significant for Compass is capability, which is now unsurpassed in the compact SUV segment. It comes now available with Jeep's Freedom Drive 2 package. Compass is trail rated for the first time. And this completes another important commitment that we made to ensure that every Jeep model in the lineup would have a true trail-rated off-road version. And that key part of Jeep DNA can be traced all the way back to the Wrangler. Well, sure-footedness also means safety. And Compass delivers with more than 30 advanced safety and security features, including electronic stability control, roll mitigation, hill start assist, side curtain airbags. And with three global powertrain options, a 2-litre, a 2.4-litre world engine, and specifically for our international markets, a 2.2-litre diesel engine, Compass delivers up to 29 miles per gallon, which includes unsurpassed 4x4 and city fuel economy. Whichever way you look at it, the 2011 Jeep Compass is designed to deliver outstanding on and off-road performance in all weather conditions. We believe that the customers will appreciate the all-new look of the Compass, along with its balanced approach of giving them unsurpassed capability in its class in a very fuel-efficient package. It certainly is a Jeep through and through. So that's the new look up at the, that's the new Jeep lineup for 2011. And I hope you will agree, we have made good on last year's promises. We have indeed touched every model, and more significantly, we've strengthened the ability of every Jeep vehicle to provide the attributes customers look for in our brand. That unique blend of capability, refinement, and of course, efficiency. But we still have a few surprises left. 2011 marks the 70th anniversary of the date that Jeep vehicles were first produced. Now, after World War II, returning soldiers, now turned civilians, sought out their tough, trustworthy comrade in arms, the Jeep. It had become the authentic benchmark for off-road capability on the roughest terrain, delivering durability and reliability in the most demanding combat conditions. So no wonder the Jeep name came to stand for personal freedom more than any other vehicle before or since. Jeep's legendary heritage, iconic brand status, and capability have made it well known and loved throughout the world. Well, that means we have a certain responsibility to the loyal following of Jeep enthusiasts. After all, it is their brand. So we need to celebrate these important milestones. And we'll be celebrating all year long with special events and promotions. But since Jeep is all about the experience driving the vehicles, we knew we had to do more. So to further commemorate the occasion, we've created 70th edition, anniversary edition models for every Jeep in the lineup. Thank you. Now, each of these 70th anniversary vehicles is unique, but each package includes thematic contenting such as distinctive paint, special 70th anniversary badging, plus unique interior detailing that really does set them apart from the rest of the pack. For example, if you look how we've treated the Grand Cherokee, it has satin, chrome painted, graphite, anodized paint, and black lacewood finish. It has unique wheels, unique leather trim with dark olive chestnut accents, unique cluster overlay, unique gauges, unique needles. As I said, each of these anniversary vehicles has distinctive content. Each vehicle, though, does take its cue from this Grand Cherokee, playing in the same color palette and offering a similar level to attention to detail, both on the exterior and the interior. So, you know, when I reflect on the 70th year of the great American Jeep, I wouldn't really be able to or dare to predict what features you're going to find in 70 years' time. But I am absolutely certain of one thing. They will continue to be the most capable vehicles in their class. So now I'd like to thank you all for spending time with us. And if you'd like to come up on stage and take a closer look at the vehicles, thank you for your time.
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more great coverage of all major motor events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive resource.